What's up, everybody? Happy Sunday. I hope that you are grateful for what the day brings. And it is now, day 51 with the 90-day challenge. So I wanted to pop out today. And since I'm not in front of the computer, I wanted to pop out and I wanted to talk to you about some free marketing strategies. Strategies that you can use to market your Shopify store, really anything that you want. And I know we talk a lot about Facebook advertising, and at this point, a lot of you have started to nail it. You've dialed it in. Facebook ads are working great for you. Some of you have invested a little bit of money. You haven't seen the returns that you've wanted yet for Facebook ads, and so you're in the looking zone for more ideas. And so if you're in the looking zone for more ideas, I just want to spend a few minutes with you. It's a Sunday, a beautiful weather outside right now in most of the country, so actually most of the world even. And so I don't want to spend too much time on this, but let's dive in to some ideas. Let's just get some creative ideas going, okay? So number one, the most important creative idea that I see working well is YouTube. It's just the number one thing, okay? YouTube. So what you want to do with YouTube is you want to find videos that exist that explain your products, or even more importantly, review them, or make videos, create videos that are just pictures and they're basically slideshows. Now, here's what I recommend you do. What I recommend is that you go on YouTube and you start studying product reviews. Take products that you find on AliExpress, and instead of just putting them on your store and hoping that they sell, why don't you go type them into YouTube and go see what other people are doing? How are other people reviewing these things? How are other people doing their videos? Are they buying the products and reviewing the product right there in front of you? Like, let's say my product is water. Are they sitting there telling you all the benefits of water? Are they showing it to you? Are they making a review video like this? Or maybe they're taking screenshots of the products and kind of putting them together and animating them and talking over them and stuff like that. Or maybe there's some sort of a viral product. Like right now, if you go take like fidget spinners, for example, and you go on YouTube and you start YouTubing fidget spinners, you're gonna see like hundreds and hundreds of videos for fidget spinners, and you're gonna see a lot of the same content repurposed, right? So once you understand that you can create, I'm not driving right now. Yeah, so Austin's like, hey, you better not be driving. No, man, I'm not driving, I'm doing good. But here's the thing is that if you have like fidget spinners as the topic of what you're doing, then what you would do is you can go in there and you can model after what's already working. And where you can basically succeed is be better than everybody else at titles, descriptions, tags, keywords, sharing the video on social media, even little things like a $5 boosted post. I know it's free traffic today, but even something as simple as a $5 boosted post to your YouTube video, just that's it. $5 lifetime value and everything. Even something as simple as that might give you an advantage over other videos. Now, another thing that's gonna give you an advantage on YouTube is gonna be quantity. Not just quality, but quantity. So if you're hoping, if you're banking on like one video being successful or two or three videos being successful, that's not the strategy. The strategy that works with YouTube is to be releasing one or two videos a day. Be releasing a lot of these things. Be releasing them five at a time if you can. Because where you start to see a lot of results in YouTube is months down the line. For example, I've got a video of my son when he was 1 year old. And what I did was I took him out to a swimming pool. Maybe he was only like 6 months old or something. I took him out to a swimming pool. I threw him in a little floaty and I filmed him. All I did was I posted it just as like a happy dad. I posted it to YouTube and just let it sit there. But the description said like, hey, 1 year old, first time in the swimming pool. Well, a couple years later, that video had 150,000 views organically. So how does it go from zero to 150,000 views? What happens is over time, as it starts collecting more views naturally, it's gonna start showing up as a related video to other YouTube videos. It's gonna start showing up on autoplay afterwards. So somebody's watching one video, a popular one with maybe a million views, and when it's done, YouTube will then autoplay your video next. And your video maybe only has 1,000 views, but it's showing up in the algorithm. So what you wanna do is you wanna do quantity more important than quality. Don't worry about getting on camera, and don't worry about doing your makeup, and don't worry about everything being perfect. Just focus on crushing out a bunch of videos all about your products. Now, if you want to review your products, instead of waiting several weeks for them to show up from AliExpress, see if you can find the exact same product on Amazon and order it with 2-day Prime shipping. And so, yes, you're going to pay more for it. You might end up paying, like, if your product costs $2 on AliExpress, it might cost $10 on Amazon. But It doesn't matter. If it's basically the same product, order from Amazon a couple days later, get it, and then do your product review. You know, do your product review. Hold up your product, talk about it, show what it looks like, show how you can use it, and that's what you want to do. You want to be making videos like this. These YouTube videos are one of the best ways, because not only can you get ranked and found in YouTube, but you can also get ranked and found in Google with the same videos. Now, take it a step further. Free traffic is also blogging. So you can take the same YouTube video, now you can write a blog post that is a review of the product. And you can use keywords that people, use descriptive keywords that people might be searching for. Think of things that people are searching for, like color variations, the material that it's used with, ways that it could be used. What problems does this product solve? Who is this product for? Is this product for a certain demographic? All of these kind of things become powerful keywords that you can put inside of your titles and inside of your descriptions. So you can create a YouTube video, you can share the YouTube video on Facebook, you can get ranked in YouTube, you can get ranked in Google, and you can embed the YouTube video on your own blog, which can be on your Shopify store, and you can do it there. You can use third-party services like ClickFunnels, and you can even build out a whole entire like long-form sales page reviewing it and talking all about it. And if you do that on your blog, you don't just have to use your own review video. You can go and find like several videos on YouTube and embed them on your blog. If it's your blog, you're allowed to embed any videos you want. If the video is on YouTube and it's embeddable, you're allowed to embed any videos you want on your blog. So this becomes just a great strategy to be able to start creating content. This helps you really capitalize on Google, YouTube, Facebook, and search engine optimization, and also starting to kick into these algorithms for related content. And it also gives you something to be sharing on your fan page inside of Facebook. So listen, if you're looking for free traffic, my advice is to jump onto the YouTube bandwagon. Jump on there. Now, if you don't want to be on camera like this, then turn the camera around and film your hands or something. So here you go. You could film your hands. You could basically be like, all right, so here's the product. Here's what it looks like. You know, it's local. It means fresh taste. It's sourced from mountain springs in the West. It's Arrowhead water. You know, as you can see, it comes in this size. That's what it looks like. There it is. And you start talking about it like this. Your face is never even on it. You can do it with your iPhone. You literally can do it with your iPhone. It's this simple, just like that, right? So you don't have to be on video. If you feel comfortable on video, be on video. If you don't, just flip it around. Make it in HD format, not portrait mode like this. Make it in landscape and just start reviewing it. Then take that video and embed it on a blog post, embed it in your Shopify store. If you're writing blog posts, again, you can use anybody's videos on all of YouTube. You can use anybody's videos, just embed them, okay? If those videos are not supposed to be there on YouTube, they'll get taken down on YouTube and your embed won't work. So you're safe. If it's on YouTube and it's embeddable, you have the right to take that embed code and put it on your blog, right? And if you get asked to take it down, just take it down, okay? So it becomes a strategy. Now you can take these, and also you can take little $5 posts. You can do page post engagement ads on Facebook to your blog post or to your YouTube video as a way to kind of boost the algorithm. So listen, yeah, that's a little bit of money. That's not free, but it's not hard to do. So I wanted to come out here on this beautiful Sunday, and I just wanted to hang with you a few minutes to encourage you. Think outside of the box with some free strategies. Join some forums related to your niche. Let's say you're in the dog niche. You should go join 100 forums that are all about dogs. You should be commenting on blog posts that are about dogs. You should be liking fan pages about dogs. You should be interacting with them. You should be joining Facebook groups about dogs. You can have a conversation. You should be joining Reddit and posting on Reddit inside of different categories about dogs. Whatever niche you're in, you should be looking, where are those communities online? Think like you're a person involved in that community. If you have a niche store and it's all about poodles, then you should join every poodle forum, every poodle Facebook group. You should like every poodle Facebook fan page. You should be commenting on all the blog posts about poodles. You should have a big bookmark on your computer, a bookmark folder of like 100 different sites and resources related to poodles. And you should be engaging in there, offering value. And every time you offer value, you can have a signature that says, hey, you're the founder of, you know, XYZ poodle store, whatever your store is, and you just start getting involved in there. And then just like Michael said, Michael in the comments right now pointed out a great resource for some more on this. On the website, ecomtutor.com, if you go to ecomtutor.com, there is a an hour-long live stream I do on 10 free traffic strategies that you guys can jump on for some more information on this. So just like Michael said, Michael, thanks for that. Somebody can post a link right now in the description. Ecomtutor.com. Go there right now if you guys want more free traffic strategies. I talk about a ton of them. Here's one more I'll leave you guys with. That's a hot one, okay? Guest blogging, okay? Go to find blogs in your niche. If you're in the nursing niche, find blogs that talk about nursing. If you're in the dog niche, find blogs that talk about dogs. If you're in the fireman niche, find dogs that find, whatever it is. Even if you're not in a specific niche, if you have a general store, what products do you sell? Are there products that maybe, let's say you sell fidget spinners, then what you can do is you can write a blog post all about fidget spinners, but your blog post might not be, your blog might not be popular. So instead of posting it on your blog, you contact blog owners and say, hey, I wrote a long blog post, about 1,500 words, all about the history of fidget spinners, where they got started, how they came about, who's the person behind it, all about the trend, all about the craze. I wrote this blog post, it's 1,500 words, it's completely unique, and if you want, I'd love to post it as a guest blog post on your blog. And by posting it on their blog, now their readers are gonna see it. Maybe it's got a better chance of getting ranked because they already have a lot of link popularity. So guest blogging is another huge thing. And in that guest blog post, you could always embed your own YouTube video in the post as well. So you guys, there's amazing opportunities out there if you're willing to hustle and grind and put in the work for those free traffic strategies. So with that, it's a Sunday. I just wanted to come at you real quick with some great ideas. And there's so many more. There's so many more. If you all have free ideas you'd like to contribute to this conversation, please leave them in the comments on this post. Have abundance, share your strategies. If you know of any great free ideas, contribute to the community and share them. Share more free ideas for people because we all want to see each other succeed. So with that being said, it's Sunday. We just got out of church. Just wanted to take some time with you guys right now. I hope you're having a blessed day and I hope that you are feeling grateful for all the abundance you have here in the 90-Day Challenge group. With that being said, Chris Record, over and out.